स्टूडेंट माई सेल्फ मिनल पवार फ्रॉम एजीएम कॉलेज कराड़। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स 10th नंबर टॉपिक मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। नाउ लेट वी कंटिन्यू। नाउ टुडे वी विल सी करंट इन स्ट्रेट लॉन्ग वायर। हाउ इज करंट फ्लोइंग टू द स्ट्रेट लॉन्ग वायर। नाउ सी हियर दिस डायग्राम। हियर दिस वन इज लॉन्ग स्ट्रेट वायर। हियर करंट आय। Here DL, here R, and here this small r and this theta angle, and P be the point here. Due to the current in long straight long wire, the how the magnetic field produced due to the long straight wire. Now that all of you know the right hand rules, that magnetic field due to the direction of the magnetic field when current flowing through the wire. Now we calculate the direction of the magnetic field. The direction of magnetic field due to current flowing through the wire here, that in this case when L be the length of the wire, that L be the length of the wire. Now we calculate the magnetic field at point P due to the distance r, perpendicular distance from r from the wire. So we calculate the magnetic field at point P due to the perpendicular distance r from the wire here. Now I be the current flowing through the wire. This I, that I is current flowing through the wire of the small element of length dl. This small element of length dl here, and due to the perpendicular distance r, r be the perpendicular distance from the point P. From the point P, now magnetic field of induction or magnitude of magnetic field at a point P due to the small element of length dl. Last lecture that we saw the Bayes-Savart's law. Therefore vector dB is equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi Idl sin theta upon r square. This one is Bayes-Savart's law. Vector dB is equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi Idl sin theta upon r square. Now we have to calculate magnetic field which produced by point P due to all current by producing here element, length of element dl due to the upper part of the infinite wire. Similarly the magnetic field produced by point P due to the all the current elements due to the lower half of infinitely long wire. Here upper part and lower part, these both the part adding together and this contribution. Now these two part, upper part and lower part, this magnetic field, the total magnetic field, the vector B is equal to adding this both the contribution, upper infinite long wires and lower infinite long wire, the vector B is equal to 2 integration of 0 to infinity vector dB. There are both the part adding together, so here we write the 2 here, that vector B is equal to 2, now substitute the value of B, 0 to infinity by using the Bayes-Savart's law, mu 0 upon 4 pi Idl sin theta upon r square. Idl sin theta upon r square. Now let's see. Now what is r? this one R square by using the right hand rules here. Then R square is equal to capital R square plus L square. Therefore, R is equal to the square root of R square plus L square. R is equal to square root of R square plus L square. Now, here 2 mu 0 upon 4 pi I integrating of 0 to infinity dl sin theta upon R square. Now here also theta is angle here. Now sin theta is equal to, the sin theta is equal to here R opposite side upon R. Therefore sin theta is equal to R upon square root of R square plus L square. R upon square root of R square plus L square. Now substitute the value of R and sin theta in equation 1 that we get. Therefore 2 mu 0 upon 4 pi I integration of 0 to infinity. Now sin theta means here R dl upon their square root of this one value. R is R square plus L square plus square root of R square plus L square. Now this equation becomes here that equation. Therefore here the 2 mu 0 I upon 4 pi 0 to infinity R upon R square plus L square 3 by 2 here. Now L square is very small to the R, so L square it can be neglected. Now here 2 here cancel, the mu 0 upon 2 pi I 0 to infinity R dl upon R cube. Therefore this equation now we can write here the mu 0 I upon 2 pi here R, that integrating term we get 1 upon R square here. Now therefore B is equal to, we obtain B is equal to here this 1 R, here R square, so this R cancel. Now remaining term is here vector B is equal to mu 0 I upon 2 pi R. It is the magnetic field due to the straight long wire. Magnetic field due to the straight long wire. This equation represent the magnetic field at the point P that produced by the perpendicular distance R on the wire. Here this equation is represent the magnetic field at point P here which perpendicular distance R from the wire here. That is magnetic field. Now the magnetic field, same the magnetic field at semi infinite wire. Now what is the magnetic field at the semi infinite wire? Therefore vector B is equal to mu 0 I upon 4 pi R. Vector B is equal to mu 0 I upon 4 pi R. This is magnetic field due to the semi infinite wire. Semi infinite wire means point is anywhere as of this straight wires. Now we get this equation vector B is equal to mu 0 I upon 4 pi R. This both the equation. Now last equation is vector B is equal to mu 0 I upon 2 pi R. This both the equation. This both the equation show that the both the equations show that magnetic field, The equation of magnetic field is inversely proportional to the distance from the r distance from the wire. Both the equations. See here, this equation also and this equation. Both the equations show that magnetic field. The magnetic field due to the wire is inversely proportional to the distance r from the that wire. The distance r. R is the distance from the wire. Okay. Now we get this magnetic field equation. Now next point is the next point. Force of attraction. The force of attraction due to long. The force of attraction due to long parallel wires. There are two long parallel wires here. Now see here. These two long parallel wires. I1, I2. Be separated by distance B. Here. Two long parallel wires separated by distance small d. Then I1 and I2 current flowing through this two wire. Now, force of attraction due to the two long parallel wires. Now, magnetic field here. The magnetic field due to the wire second. This one second wire. This one is first wire. Magnetic field due to the wire second. Due to the current of wire first. Then magnetic field B is equal to. By using last equation, mu 0 I1 upon 2 pi d. Now what? This equation represents magnetic field due to the wire second and current of the wire first. B is equal to mu 0 I1 2 pi d. Now according to right hand rules, due to the direction of the current is perpendicular to the plane of the paper. Here, this direction of the current is perpendicular. Both the wires having the current I1 and I2. These two currents are perpendicular to the plane of the papers. Now, according to Lorentz force, we had learned this Lorentz force in this chapter. Now, according to Lorentz force, due to the force applying the wire second, due to magnetic field of wire first. Now, F is equal to, this equation F can be write, F is equal to I2, the current of force applying the wire second, the current of I2. Here B, this value, mu 0 I1 upon 2 pi d integrating dl. Now, this equation, this one equation first, this is equation second. Both these two forces that moving toward the wires, so these forces is called attractive forces. When these two forces are moving toward the wire, so these forces are called attractive forces. attractive force. Now shear force due to the infinite long wire. Here is two parallel wires. If there are infinite long wire, there force also is here. Force is also infinite here. For infinite current, for infinite wire, there is force also infinite wire. Forces is infinite. Therefore, force per unit length F dash is equal to mu zero I one I two upon 2 pi d. Mu zero I one upon I two 2 pi. Now see, this one is force per unit length F dash mu zero I one I two upon 2 pi d. Now when here L is the capital L is, now capital L is length of the wires, that capital L is length of the wire. L is length of wire, length of wire. Here force F21, we can write the force of the second wire due to magnetic field of first wire. We can write here I2BL. Then I2B means, by using last equation, current due to the magnetic field due to straight wire, mu zero I one upon 2 pi d L. Combining, we can write F21 is equal to mu zero I one I two upon 2 pi d into L. The equation here, now equation is first here. Now this is force acting on wire second due to current of first. Similarly, F12 is opposite to the F21. Here, this means force of the first wire due to the current of the second wire. It is oppositely directed, means minus sign here. Mu zero I one I two upon 2 pi d L. These two forces we can write F21 is equal to minus F12. F21 is equal to minus F12. This force due to the wire second due to the current of first wire. Force due to the wire first, current of the second wires. Now see here, when force per unit length, the force per unit length, the force of attraction, force of attraction, the force per unit length F is equal to mu zero I one I two upon 2 pi d. This equation for force of attraction per unit length L cancel, here cancel. Now force of repulsion per unit length, repulsion per unit length, F is equal to mu zero I one I two upon 2 pi d. These two equation, that like current are attract towards each other and unlike current are repel to each other. By this equation we can conclude that like current, the like current, now these two like currents here, that like current means parallel current attract, parallel current attract to each other. Anti-parallel current repel to each other, repel. Like current attract, like means parallel current. not like here. Parallel current attract to each other, anti-parallel current repel to each other. Here we get force of attraction per unit loop, per unit length, that F is equal to mu 0 I 1 I 2 upon 2 pi d, and force of repulsion, here we get F is equal to mu 0 I 1 I 2 upon 2 pi d. Now here next article is magnetic field due to current produced by circular arc of wire. Now here magnetic field due to the current produced by circular arc of the wire. Here is arc of the wire. Here O, theta, vector dB, I, current AB. R and I current is flowing through here, the arc of the wire. Considering straight parallel wire, let us obtain the magnetic field. Magnetic field means B due to the circular arc of the wires. Magnetic field due to this circular arc of the wire. Circular arc of the wire AB be the circular arc of the wire. Circular arc of wire here, that I be the current flowing through this circular arc of the wire. I be the current flowing through the circular arc of the wire, that magnetic field. We obtain the magnetic field due to the current flowing through the towards the length of small element. Current flowing towards the length of small element dl. Now here, when the circular arc of the wire AB suspended at angle theta. The circular arc of the wire suspended means like this here, at angle theta, made by angle theta, at O be the is the part of the circular arc of the wire here. O be the part of the circular arc of the wire. Now according to Bayes' law, that vector dB is equal to, in case of inverse square law, we can write mu 0 upon 4 pi I vector dl cross vector r upon r cube. In inverse square law, in case of inverse square law, Bayes' law, we can write here mu 0 upon 4 pi I vector dl cross vector r upon r cube. Now simplify this equation, we can write vector dB is equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi I dl upon r square. By simplification of Bayes' law, we can write here now vector dB is equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi I dl upon r square. These give the magnitude of magnetic field. The direction of magnetic field by using right hand rules. Here also we can use the right hand rules. The direction of magnetic field due to the right hand rules, that same as that thumb, outstretched thumb indicate the direction of current. This curl of finger indicate the direction of magnetic field here. Now that magnetic field, the total magnetic field B is equal to integrating vector dB, that the integrating this our equation, that A to B mu 0 upon 4 pi ideal upon R square, mu 0 upon 4 pi ideal upon R square, that A to B here, A to B means 0 to theta, mu 0 upon 4 pi ideal upon R square. This equation we can write here, 0 to theta in bracket terms here, mu 0 upon 4 pi integrating 0 to theta I dl upon R square. Now dl is equal to, here dl is equal to length of small element, dl is equal to here dl, I give the current here, you can show here also, that dl is equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi I 0 to theta R d theta upon R square. Here R cancel, mu 0 I upon the mu 0 I upon 4 pi here upon R into theta. That combined you can write B is equal to mu 0 I theta upon 4 pi R. This is magnetic field due to current produced by circular arc of the wire. Here theta is in radian. Here theta is in radian. B is equal to mu 0 I theta upon 4 pi R. Here next article is magnetic field at the center of magnetic field at the center of full circle of wire. That full circle of wire carrying current I. Carrying current I here. Now this equation for circular arc of equation, vector B is equal to mu 0 I theta upon 4 pi R. Now magnetic field at the center of full circle of wire, instead of theta we can write 2 pi mu 0 I upon 4 pi R theta. Here full circle, so here we can write here 2 pi. Here is full circle is given, so mu 0 I upon 4 pi R into 2 pi, pi pi cancel, here 2, that equation becomes B is equal to mu 0 I upon 2, the mu 0 I upon 2 R. This equation represent magnetic field at the center of full circle of wire carrying current I due to the magnetic field is given. Here magnetic field B is given here. This one is magnetic field for circular arc of the wire. Let me revise. magnetic field or circular arc of the wire B is equal to mu 0 I theta upon 4 pi r. Now this equation is represent magnetic field at the center of full circle of wire carrying current. Here full circle of wire, we get equation here, this one, and this one is circular arc of equation. Now thank you.